Southern resident killer whales are endangered, and we're trying to find out if it's because they can't get enough salmon to eat.
Our study uses hydroacoustic technologies to look at beneath the surface of the ocean, trying to figure out how many fish there are, what kind of fish there are, and where they are. Konnichiwa, Sato Mei desu. 私は今、British Columbia 大学でオルカとサケの生態系について調べています。Southern resident killer whales are very picky on what they feed on. So there are 5 different species of salmon in British Columbia, and they feed on mostly Chinook salmon. That's the most energy rich and the largest among all the species. So what we are trying to do is to figure out whether there is enough Chinook salmon for southern resident killer whales to feed.
Part of our study is trying to compare the declining southern resident population with the increasing northern residents. When we look at their body conditions, the southern residents are thinner on average compared to the northern residents. And that's our strongest clue to suggest that the problem is food availability. They're simply not getting enough to eat.
So our typical day starts 4 in the morning. We wake up and quickly eat the breakfast and pack up the van with the gear and then drive to the marina. And so when we get to the marina, we load all our gear to the small vessel and then leave the marina by 6 a.m. Once we get to the site, we deploy the CTD, which measures conductivity, temperature, and pressure, providing us some environmental parameters where the Chinook salmons are staying. Then we use the multi-frequency echo sounders, which have 4 frequencies from 38 to 200 kilohertz. By having multiple frequencies, we can separate fish from zooplankton or perhaps a different species of the fish.
So we're using technology to find fish. In fact, we're using the same technology that killer whales have used forever. They too send out sound and it bounces off the prey back to them and they get it in their melon. And from that, they can visualize what's there. And they're finely tuned to identify Chinook salmon in particular and go for them.
Killer whales can like sweep across the frequencies. So I'm pretty sure they're getting way more information than we have. So that's why probably they can detect the Chinook from other salmon. We are using a similar technology, but not quite yet as sophisticated as the killer whales using. And also we need a small vessel to deploy it, and we also need to validate with the small sport fishing techniques.
When we look at the surface, it almost looks like a desert, and it's hard for us to imagine how rich these waters are. And yet, if you look at the surface, you see the seabirds that are feeding. You see the seals, the sea lions, the white-sided dolphins, the humpback whales. This is such a rich ocean. And it's been, therefore, so puzzling when we look at the southern residents, because everybody else is doing so well. The southern residents are an outlier. Why can't they make it when all the other species that are feasting on all this prey that are in the ocean are doing so well? Why can't the southern resident killer whales do it as well? And that's been so puzzling to us, and we hope to get to the bottom of it. When we're looking at a problem as serious as why are southern resident killer whales declining, you think, well, maybe a killer whale specialist could answer that question themselves. But in fact, we need more than just a killer whale biologist. We need people who understand acoustics, who understand how to look for fish underwater. We need to work with nutritionists. We need to work with laboratories that can analyze the fish. It takes a whole team to come together to solve this problem.